Hello everyone. In this video, we are going to talk about chemical substances and processes. So I have divided the whole chapter into three videos. This is the first video. In it, we are going to cover matter, atom, molecule, pure substances, element, compound and mixtures. So let's start with the first one. It is matter. What is matter? Anything that has mass and occupies space is known as matter. Suppose take the example of this marker. It has mass. Mass means all the atoms and particles and molecules inside it. And it occupies the space. So it is known as matter. Matter is anything that has mass and occupies space. So now we are familiar with the space. But what is mass? Mass is made up of particles like atoms and molecules. So mass is made up of particles like atoms and molecules. So let's begin again. We have understood the matter, but again the matter is divided into solid, liquid and gas. So let's first take example of solid. And solid can be again this marker. It's a solid structure. And let's take example of liquid. And we are familiar with it is water and it is liquid. It's also matter. And the third one is gas. And if I have this balloon, in it I have put air, so air is in the form of gas. So matter exists in three forms: solid, liquid and gas. Again, there are two other forms of matter. There are plasma, that is in stars, and there is Bose Einstein condensate. Anything which is perma frozen, which is, has a very much minus degree Celsius temperature, that is known as Bose-Einstein condensate. But for 7th standard, we are going to study solid, liquid and gas. That is the three stages of matter. So now the question arises that what is matter made up of? Suppose again I have this water and you see every molecule and atom in it. If I divide it or if I go on dividing it, or if I have this marker and if I cut it into two pieces, suppose I have this again take an example of any brick. This building brick, and I divide into two pieces, again into four pieces, the smaller one, again into a number of smaller pieces. What would be the last thing left? That would be atoms. So matter, the whole matter is made up of atoms. And how do we define atoms? Atom is the smallest unit of matter. Atom, smallest unit of matter. So the last thing that is left with the matter is atom. Atom is the smallest unit of matter. If we go on the wording of the atom, it has two divisions, and atom. The word atom means division. Division. And if you attach A into it, it becomes atom. And if you attach A into it, the division becomes no. No division. It means it's the smallest unit which cannot be divided further. Now again, the second term we are covering is a molecule. Now we have molecule. What's molecule? when two or more atoms combine together. Two or more atoms combine together. When atoms combine, they make up molecules. Let us take an example. If you have an H atom and you have another H atom, they will combine and they will form H2. This is molecule and these are a single atoms. So two or more atoms combine to make a molecule. So the question is, why the atoms combine? Because most of the atoms cannot exist in the pure form. They have to combine with another and make the molecule. So let's take example. These are N2. It's also a molecule. In it there are two N atoms. Again there is H2. It has two H atoms. So again there is Cl2. It has two Cl atoms. So now a molecule is when two or more, what's more, it is S8, in which there are 8 atoms of sulfur. It's also a molecule. So now these are the molecules in which the atoms are same. Again take example of water, H2O. It's again a molecule. Because we have taken the definition as two or more, in which there are 3 atoms. Two H and one oxygen. One oxygen and two H, there are 3 atoms. So the molecule can have the same atoms and the different atoms. So now let's take an example. Let's do some exercise. So now let's differentiate. What are these? This is a single one and it is atom. Now there are two atoms of N, N for nitrogen. So it is molecule. There are two, when two or more atoms combine together, they form the molecule. So it is molecule. Now there is a single atom of O. So it is atom, and if two or more are there, and they can be molecule. It is will be again atom, and these are 4 atoms. One is Fe and 3 are Cl. So it is a molecule of FeCl3. Again this water, it has 3 atoms, so it will be a molecule. And in it there are 8 sulfur molecules, so it will be molecule. And this will be again molecule. And it has 2 atoms, sodium and chlorine. So it will be a molecule. So now atom is the smallest unit of matter and it cannot exist alone. It has to make molecules to balance itself. Okay. So the molecule, when two atoms or more atoms combine together, those two atoms can be same or different. So there are two concepts, atoms and molecules. We are clear with atoms and molecules. And do not confuse these atoms and molecules with element, compound and mixtures, because these are the separate concept and these are the another separate concept. So we are clear with atom, molecule. Now let's begin a study about the pure substances. What are the pure substances? These are pure substances, same kind of particles. Same kind of, you can say particles, or you can write same kind of atoms or molecules. So now if the atoms or the molecules are same kind, those are known as pure substances. So let's further divide it. There can be same atoms, there can be same molecules. On the basis, there are atoms and compounds. The atom and compound is the pure substance, but mixture is not a pure substance. The pure substances are element and compound. So now again, our next topic is element. So it's a pure substance and we will call it same kind of atoms. If the atoms are same kind, we call it element. Like if you have an example of Fe, all the atoms I am concentrating on this term. This is the same kind of term. So Fe, in this all the atoms will be of Fe. If I write here N2, this is also an element because it has same number of atoms, so it is an element. So now again, can I write H2O as element? It will be no, because it has two kind of, there is hydrogen and there is oxygen. They are different. If they are different, they are not element. If they are same, we call element. The same atoms means element, the different atom means something different. So let's understand in this way. Again we have, let's understand first compound. In this, same kind of molecules in fixed ratio. So this is the definition. In the previous definition of element, we have said same kind of, because these are the pure substance, so the particles will be of same kind. But in atom, what are same? In element, what are same? Atoms. In compound, what are same? Molecules. And in a fixed ratio. They are combined in the fixed ratio. Let's understand how. Let's take example of water. Why do we call it pure substance? Because it has same kind of molecules, not the atoms. So it's one molecule of compound. And in the molecules, the atoms are different. In the molecules, the atoms are different. When we understood molecule, we said that in a molecule, the atom can be same and the atom can be different. So, in the compound, those molecules are there in which the atoms are different. In which there is H and O. O for oxygen, H for hydrogen. So, atoms are different and they have a fixed ratio. They have two atoms of H and one of O. So, they have this fixed ratio. If I change it and I make it H3O, it will not be water. Because the fixed ratio, two atoms of H and one of O is changed into 3H. So it does not have fixed ratio, so it is not the same compound. So let's understand what is compound. It's a pure substance in which all there are same kind of molecules, and in the molecules the atoms are different and they are combined in a fixed ratio. If they don't have the fixed ratio, they not will be a compound. So let's move further on to the mixture. Two or more compound in fixed ratio, in any ratio. In any ratio. So take an example of compound, it's H2O, and I have put NaCl into it. So this has become a mixture. There are two compounds, one compound and two compound, and there can be further. If I add sugar into it, if I add sugar, this will not again be a compound because it has any ratio. There is no fixed ratio of all the things. So now let's find element, compound and mixture among all this written over here. And before I begin there, I want to tell you that if you have this hammer and this iron piece over it, so I have to find out where is that iron in it. So let's find out. It's right here. It is Fe. I should write atom or molecule over it. It is atom as well as element. Okay. So in this, the all atoms, not molecules, all atom will be of Fe, and this is also called, if the same atom are there, then it we call it element. So this is made up of element Fe. So now again, if I have water here, water is there, and in this water I have to find out here what is water, and it is right here. This is water and it has two kind of hydrogen and oxygen. There are two kind of atoms, so I also call it molecule, and they are fixed in a ratio and they are different atoms, so this will be a compound also. So water is known as compound. Again, if I mix, this is NaCl, and I have to find it out here. So it is right here, in which there is sodium and chlorine, and they have a fixed ratio and they are different atoms, so I can call it compound as well as one molecule. But if I mix NaCl with water, let us take some NaCl and mix it with water. So I have mixed in water, I have no any fixed ratio. So what is right now, it is a mixture. When two or more compound mix together, it is known as mixture. So let me find it out here, NaCl, and how do I write it? I have to write NaCl H2O. So now what is, there are two compounds and I will call it mixture. Okay, this is known as mixture. Again, if I have this air, air is inside it. Air has all, air has nitrogen, oxygen, number of other gases are also, carbon dioxide is also there. So this they are in different proportions. So this is known as a mixture. Air is also a mixture. Let's find it out by one. N2, we call it atom and we also call it element because atoms are same. And here I have H, the all H are same, if so it is also an element. FeCl3, there are two kind of atoms, they are different and they have fixed ratio, so this is compound. Sa, there are 8 atoms of S. Atoms same kind are known as elements. This will be element. So H2, there are two same kind of that atoms, so it will be an element. CuSO4, it's a compound. Copper is there and sulfur and oxygen, so it is compound. And Cu is one only, so it is element. Na, one only is same kind of atoms, it is element. And FeSO4 and H2O, two compound, two or more compound are mixture. Okay, so now NaCl, H2O and FeCl, now there are three compound, three compound mix called in any proportion, it is mixture. Al, aluminium alone will be element. AlCl3, there are two kind of atoms, in they are different also and they are fixed ratio, so this is compound. And K, the one only, it will be element. KCl, two atoms, different fixed ratio, compound. And this would be KCl and H2O, two compounds are mixed, so this will be mixture. In this way, you can find it out what is compound, element or mixture. And do not mix atoms and molecules. They are different concept and this is a different concept. Thank you very much.